Namaskaram, Vanakkam, and good morning, Imzansi. You are watching your ultimate Hindu magazine program, Sadhana, the Inward Path, right here on SABC3. On the show today, we meet the iconic Yogambal Singaram, who shares her family's journey through the arts. To warm us up a bit, Anuradha treats us to a special butternut and chickpea coconut curry on conscious cooking, and then we nourish our mind and body with more yoga for wellness and lessons from the Tirukural. The Singarams have made an indelible mark on the South African music and dance landscape for the past 40 years. Husband and wife duo Yogambal and the late Pregaladan Singaram, accomplished in South Indian arts, dedicated much of their lives in nurturing hundreds of students through their school, the PNY Singaram Kala Kendra. Theirs is a family steeped in Ayal, Isay and Nadagam, language, music and dance. We found out more when we met the doyen of dance herself, Yogambal Singaram, at her Durban home recently.
Parents used to watch a lot of Tamil movies, and we used to go off to the Rani Theatre and watch movies there. And I got very interested. While watching movies, I saw this lovely dancing, and I used to perform in my lounge and run around the house. And my mother saw this interest in me, and then she said I should enroll at a dance class. And I was just about grade 3 at the time, and my mom used to take me to classes all the way to the Himalaya Hotel where Jay Lakshmi Naidu was there, and I began my dance classes there. And then I spent about 13 years with Jay Lakshmi, and I was one of the 5 girls to first Arangetram ever in South Africa. Yes, and it was an amazing event at the Kane Grovers Hall, at the Emerald Sultan, Kane Grovers Hall, and the community for the first time experienced an Arangetram. After having had my Arangetram locally with Jay Lakshmi, I began teaching for her school because she got married and went off to Canada. And I was glad that she could entrust me with a school of about 100 students at the Saivasatanda Sangam in Chatsworth. And I enjoyed this, but I still felt there was still something missing, because it's, you don't know enough. There's always something to learn. So my parents have noticed that, so they decided to send me off to India at their own expense. And this was a great sacrifice in that time. When I had my Arangetram in India with my guru, Pregaladan was in the audience, because he studied Mridangam in India as well, and he studied the art of Mridangam playing under Guru Madras Ekanan. And I don't know whether he had tracked me down, and he invited me to perform at his debut performance, and then of course the rest was history. We used to be called the Nirtya Kala Kendra initially, and after we married, after some time, we decided to incorporate the school and call it the PNY Singaram Kala Kendra. And the school grew. We had taken students overseas. When we both set up the school, we decided we were not going to do a fusion. No matter how many carrots you dangle in front of us, we were not prepared to do it. And today the school is 41 years old, and I'm proud to say that I've honored what my husband had also wanted. People generally feel that if you do pure Bharatanatyam, it is boring. Or classical music, Carnatic music is boring. I wish somebody or people could take the time to explore the beauty and the essence of classical music and classical dance. Prabhupada used to always say, Saraswati was given to us freely. And if she so desires, she can also take this away from us. It is all left in her hand. So therefore, I would always say to everybody, including my students, respect the art form. It was a higher power that got us together, and we were able to impart this knowledge, this pure art form, to the general community after our marriage. And then of course we had two lovely daughters, one being Shri and the other being Arasi. Shri had an Arangetram under my guidance as well many years ago. My other daughter, who had an Arangetram much later in life, they always say that no two children are the same. She didn't show much interest initially, but after Prahladan's demise, that's when Arasi had an Arangetram. We presented one item which her father played. It was a Mridangam piece, and it was a beautiful moment, and the audience really cried during that moment because Prahladan played. We used a recording of his, and we set the dance piece, and we brought down a picture of Prahladan onto the stage, and it was a very emotional moment. But I was happy. I feel proud that I was able to do an Arangetram for both my children, and they were able to follow in whatever, you know, Prahladan and I did. I went to India, and in India I was given the special honour by the government of India for my contribution to the arts. My husband was there as well, and he was honoured for his contribution as well at this event. The relationship was so good in that that trust was there, and even though he left, that energy is still there. With that energy, I'm able to get around and still continue with my work, because I could never do that work if I didn't get that energy from a higher power, and that is the Lord. And I still think Prahladan is there to guide us and guide our family.
Thank you.